After the Aussies changed their deportation policies in 2014, would you believe New Zealanders now make up the top group in Australia's deportation facilities? Is it justified? To discuss, we're joined by Professor Paul Spoonley from Massey University. Morena.
Morena, Jack.
Thanks for being here. Can you just tell us how the deportation rules work with the Aussies at the moment?
Essentially, it's a character test. So if you fail that character test, your visa is revoked. And that can be actioned as soon as you get a sentence of 12 months. But I would point out there are quite a few New Zealanders who have been deported back to New Zealand who actually haven't been convicted. And that is because of another aspect of the character test, which is that if you have an association with a known criminal organisation.
Right, which could be a biker gang, for example.
Yes, the Comancheros or the Rebels. So we're starting to import biker gangs from Australia.
Is it
import's the wrong word.
Yeah. Is it a reasonable measure, that character test?
No, and I think the whole thing has been a disgrace, to be honest. First of all, we have a particular relationship with Australia, which the changes in 2014 have really peeled back. Mm. And the other thing is, of course, that many of the people that are being deported have no association with New Zealand. So Dutton, who of course is now on the back benches, has been a very hardline minister. Mm. He's had a lot of his decisions overturned by the appeals tribunal, I would point out.
In some respects, then, it's probably a good thing for trans-Tasman relations that Dutton didn't win the Prime Ministership yesterday?
Yes, except that the Minister now is Scott Morrison, who introduced those 2014 regulations. And the Prime Minister, even though he is on the more liberal part of the spectrum, has not taken a backward step. I mean, this year, Ardern, Little, Peters have all taken on the Australian government and have got nowhere.
But that must be because, from a domestic perspective, this would be a pretty popular policy, wouldn't it?
Precisely, and I think it's against Turnbull's own inclinations, because I think he would be more liberal on immigration, but that base, that base, political base in Australia and within his own Liberal Party is very, very strong on immigration.
In saying that, we wouldn't want to be harbouring criminals in New Zealand that might easily be deported overseas, would you?
No,
one wants that sort of thing.
No.
What would be a reasonable measure?
Well, can I just answer the first part of that, Jack? And that is that all countries should have the right to deport people who have committed crimes. So we actually deport Australians.
Yeah.
But since 2015, only 10 of them.
Right.
Whereas Australia has deported 1,300 New Zealanders back to New Zealand.
That is a huge discrepancy.
It is. And remember that 12 months is a light sentence. It could be misdemeanours, it could be quite minor charges. And the Australians are then using that as the basis for saying, you're not welcome anymore in Australia. Even if you've been here since you're 1, 2, 3 years old, you spent 30 or 40 years of your life. Or if you go back to New Zealand.
And you have no ties whatsoever, no family in New Zealand.
No, we're becoming a dumping ground for those criminals, really. Mm. And we are struggling, because if you look at the rates once they get back here in terms of then committing crimes here, we've got an issue.
So what might be a more reasonable measure?
Well, I think we've got to talk to the Australians about equity between the two countries. We've been the good guys in this, and at the moment the big brother is just saying, no, go away. They really need to come to the table, but I see no signs of that at the moment with this government in Australia.
All right, thanks for your time. Thanks, really appreciate it as always. Professor Paul Spoonley.